I like this. My intro act was a schedule. How about that? Thank you so much. That was great. She got it. Okay, great. We're gonna keep this short because we got a band up next, but and most of them are here, right? Cool, that's awesome. You're there, like, please don't take too long. I got it. I did a comedy show for kids in New York City, so we're gonna do a bunch of games that I used to do in the show. Does that sound good? So I'm gonna pretend like most of you all are kids. Is that okay?
All right.
Danny, I know that's okay with you.
Good.
You're all good with that. Okay, right. But I'm also going to try some new jokes once in a while. And one of the things I think is hilarious about living up here, when I used to live in New York City, is the recorder headlines, right? Because they're just so, like, benign. Like, it's like I saw one that's like a light on a bridge change. They literally made that the headline. And so I did, like, a project of, like, comparing recorder headlines to New York Post headlines. And my favorite one was literally on the same day was the recorder said, Greenfield Center School's outdoor toileting practice raises concern from health officials. Do you remember that one?
Yeah.
The Daily News at the same time was one-legged accused shoplifter who urinated on cops busted again after being released without bail. So that is, that's where we came from. You get it. Okay, I like this. You got like a plan. This is great. This is gonna be good. Okay, all right. Well, that's all I got for now. Okay. Should we start with this love hate? Does any kids have any jokes you want to tell? Any kids? One of my favorite kid jokes is why can't you trust a jungle cat?
Why can't you trust a
lion? Because they're either a cheetah or a lion. Lion. Sorry. Okay. Any kids want to tell a joke? What do you got? Oh my. Okay, this is great. Okay.
Knock knock.
Knock knock. Who's there?
Interrupting cow.
Boo. That was a solid one. I like that. That is a classic.
I got one.
Oh yeah, what do you got, Danny?
What happens when a herd of giraffes going one way runs into a herd going the other way?
What?
It's a giraffe jam.
That was almost funny. That was the attempt was the funny part. So I got it. Thank you. That's great. I like the other classic one I always love. Does everyone know Talking Muffin? Okay, no. It's what did one Talking Muffin say to the other?
What?
Oh my God, a Talking Muffin! That's a great joke, right? That's awesome. Anyway, you got another kid joke? What do you got? If anybody has any kid jokes, you're welcome to throw them in. I'm really taking it easy, taking the burden off myself. Okay, we got some good stuff here. Let me tell some jokes, some kid-oriented jokes. So this is, I'm gonna have a pile here of jokes that work and jokes that don't work. Okay? All right. So you guys have to help me figure out if these jokes work. There's a good pile and a bad pile, okay? I got invited to a destination wedding in Hartford, Connecticut. That's just a wedding. I like that, really? Okay. It's not a destination, it's just a wedding. It's just, all right, okay. All right. Well, now? Okay. I like that joke. Okay, let's go to the good pile. Right.
What do you need us for?
I know, well, I think...
How the hell is that going in anyway?
I'll put it in the needs work pile. Okay. Anybody know Dora the Explorer?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you know, you guys don't know, Diana does not know Dora the Explorer. Do you know Dora the Explorer? Okay, well, Dora, she's an adventurer, a kid's adventurer, my one problem with Dora the Explorer is that she can't differentiate a crisis situation from a non-crisis situation.
She's a boy.
And she's a girl. She's, okay. Yeah. And she's a boy. Boys can't differentiate. Okay, but stores can't differentiate crisis from non-crisis situations. And so, like, I feel like it's like the worst characteristic because every show she treats everything the same. She's like, oh no, we have to save Baby Pooh from falling off the cliff. Very next episode, same exact tone. Oh no, we have to get to Diego's birthday on time. Like, these are very different things, you know, Dora. In one episode, you go over Alphabet Mountain, you save the puma. The other just call Abuelo and be like, hey, we'll be late. Tell Diego we love him. Gracias. Yeah. Sometimes I tell that joke, I've told that joke in, like, comedy clubs without, like, first saying I have kids. Which just makes it seem like I'm really into Dora the Explorer. Like, I sit around my house going like, of course he's gonna keep swiping, his name is literally Swiper! Yeah, that's a good one, right? Okay. So my mom is here, clap it up for her. She's happy Mother's Day to you, Mom. She's a wonderful mom who I'm about to tell some jokes about.
Okay.
Yeah, but don't worry, she's a little forgetful, so she's gonna love me in an hour anyway. Okay. But it's great. There was a restaurant that I was recommending to her go to. It was like 15 minutes away, and we were right near it. I was like, you should go check out that restaurant. And by the time we got home, I was like, hey, you should go to that restaurant. She's like, yeah, people have been talking about that restaurant. Okay. Is that good? Or it just needs work. I'm gonna say, okay, right, she laughed, okay. All right, I'll do one more, then we'll do the hate and the love. Okay. I saw a sign, a billboard recently, or a couple years ago, that it was from a barn company. And you know what their advertisement was?
What?
They say, barns, what would you do with a barn? And like, the market for barns really fell out the table, right?
Yeah.
They're just like, hey, what would you do with our product? We don't really know. Like, there must have been some intern who was like, hey, what if we, you know, say, hey, do you need a place to store grain and put cows? And they were like, no one does that anymore. Okay. All right, was that good or bad?
Okay. Well, the sign is directed at the wife. She goes, I'll get goats, I'll get bunnies, I'll get ponies, get us a barn.
Okay, so you're saying I just don't get it. Okay. You like barn, you're in a pro-barn world, okay. Okay, I usually have more of an anti-barn crowd. All right, we'll do some of these love hates. Let's see. All right, clap up for all the moms. Hey, happy Mother's Day. So great. So we ask people to do things they love and things they hate about either being a mother or their mother. And we accept insurance if you put a lot in here. Okay, so things we love about moms. You are so nice. Oh. That's so sweet, right? That was you? Nice. You're gonna get some, are you buttering her up for candy or something? Okay, she thinks maybe yes. Okay. Some other nice thing is the best hugs. Oh, that's nice. That's sweet. Okay, so two hates. Okay, these are funnier, I think. She doesn't let me watch videos. Okay, I know who that is. That's my daughter. Okay. Does your mom let you watch as much TV as you want? Okay, no. It's weird, my mom, she lives with me, and it's weird, because like when I was a kid, she used to tell me, you know, turn off the TV, go outside and make some friends, and now I have to tell her that. Okay, great, okay, thank you, okay. The thing they hate is teenage years, apparently. That is a terrible, bad, all right, okay, no teenagers here. They really stink, right? What's up with teenagers? Okay. I have a teenage daughter who, I haven't told her the pandemic's over. That's fine, I just want her in the house. I told her I'm gonna go buy some masks now.
Does she always wear masks?
Yeah.
Everywhere she goes?
Yeah, she has to wear, no, I'm joking about that. What's that? What's that, Diana? Okay, all right, one more love and we're here. Okay, one love we got, growing up with my son. Oh, that's very sweet. I hope that's my mom. Okay.
She goes, I didn't do that.
Sorry. Lynn, could you? Sorry
about that. At the same time, you said, I hope that's my mom.
Sorry.
Was that love or hate?
That was love. Oh, yeah, that could be love or hate. That's true. It depends on the sun. Thank you, Lynn. All right. Sorry. Okay. That's pretty good. Okay, good stuff here. All right. So usually at this point, I would do games with kids. Okay, so we could still try it though, right? You still want to try it? Okay, any kids want to volunteer? Come on, Diana. You want to volunteer for a game?
Yeah.
Yeah, come on up. Okay, all right. Let's do this. look very mean. Okay, great. Okay. So, clap it up for the kids, everybody. Can you say your names in here? What's your name?
My name is Ellie.
Yeah, clap it up for Ellie. Yeah. Okay. All right. So you guys step right here. Okay. We're gonna do impressions. We'll do an impression. How about you guys versus? Does any adult want to do some impressions? We could be like adults versus kids. Any adults want to do it with me? Andrew. Okay. This is being recorded. Okay. All right. So this is gonna be kids versus me. How about that? We'll see who wins. Kids or me? Okay. All right, so the first impression is a mean teacher. Ellie, you want to do a mean teacher impression? No? Dan, you want to do it?
You don't want to, I could. I have a good one.
Yeah, show me what you got. You got to show
Stop
me.
It, fudge!
Stop it, fudge. I like that. All right, that's great. High five, Ellie. Yeah, there we go. Do you want me to do one, then you try to beat me? Okay, because I can get my daughter, if she wants to beat me on things, okay. So mean teacher is, you didn't do your homework, you're in trouble now. What do you got?
You didn't do the right thing at school.
Nice. There we go. Okay, so who wins? Kids? Everybody clap. Clap for kids. Clap for kids. Clap for me. Clap for kids. Oh, I think I won. Good job, everybody. Okay. I think kids win. Kids win. You guys get right. Okay, you got good job. Good job. Oh, cool. Oh, man. Okay. Does anybody have any kid jokes they want to tell? Yeah, what you got, Ellie?
Forgot.
Okay. There's some in the book. Danny, what do you got?
What does the porcupine say to the hedgehog?
What does a porcupine say to the hedgehog? What?
I porcupine love you.
How sweet is that? That is so great. I love like kids when the kids do this, they just start like free flowing about what jokes are. Like it's great. What do sea monsters like to eat? Fish and ships.
That's good.
I didn't make that up.
I just swallowed a spoon. What should I do? Lie down and don't stir.
That's good. What do you get the person who has everything? A burglar alarm. By the way, I think one of the great things about living here is that like you really don't have to like even lock the doors, not true apparently. Melissa, who lives way out of the country, thinks this is the big city and like locks everything and has my mom. Carry a gun or something. No, not a gun.
She wasn't supposed to tell you about when I put the chairs under the knob.
Okay, what do you got?
What do you get when you cross an elephant with a fish?
What do you get when you cross an elephant with a fish? What?
Swimming trunks.
Swimming trunks. That's pretty great. That's pretty great.
Here's our favorite.
Yeah.
Knock, knock. Who's knock, knock?
Who's there?
Bacon.
Bacon.
We're baking some cookies.
Yeah.
What's the address?
That's pretty good. Okay. Right.
Yes. One day Paul called me and he said, "My mom's eating too many cookies." And I said, "I got a cookie in my hand. What's your point?"
Melissa, we should go on the road together. Yeah, okay.
What happens when you get a cow and a duck together? What do you have?
What?
Milk and quackers.
That's pretty good. Why is it hard to tell if a pterodactyl's in your bathroom? Because its pee is silent. Good, right? Okay. Oh, man. I'll do a couple more jokes here, then we could do their game or something. What time we got? Okay, how are we doing time? Okay, that's not so bad. Okay. That was not so good. Parenting during the pandemic. Boy, the pandemic, sure, that was something, right? I had a friend of mine, single people had lived different worlds than like family people. I had a friend of mine, he's like, if you get in a fight with your wife, you should just, go for a walk, you know, cool off, that's what you do. So I'm like, what if the whole fight was about who gets to go for the walk? Like, the winner was the one who gets to go for the walk, you know? Right, that was pretty good, okay. I'm gonna put him in there, okay. Hey, mermaids, right? Did they evolve from fish or from people?
Fish and people.
Fish and people? It's not a real joke, it's just like an observation. It's really stunning. I like you guys were like counting on a punchline there. Yeah. That's good. I appreciate that. You guys want to, I don't do a lot of impressions, but I will. You guys want to hear my impression of Ariel the mermaid singing?
Oh, please.
Yeah. You ready? Okay.
I've always wanted.
This is being recorded, fortunately. Okay, ready? Blub, 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 blub. Because she's underwater. How do mermaids sing underwater? I don't know.
Because they're mermaids.
Because that doesn't answer any questions. Okay. Oh, man. All right. We'll do one more. Come one more joke. Okay, that's been solid. Those have been solid jokes, right? Okay. Man, I love optimistic stores. Does everyone love optimistic stores? My favorite optimistic store is Marshall's. You guys know Marshall's? They don't really have them around here, do they?
Yeah, they do.
A little bit. I love them because their slogan is, you'll love surprises. Because it's another way of saying, hey, welcome, we have a bunch of random stuff in here.
That no other store's wanted.
That no other store is wanted. Like, if you don't know what Marshall's is, it's a thrift store where everything's exactly 3 years old. But, like, I love it. Like, you go to Marshall's, you're like, hey, I'd like a polo shirt. Like, guess what? We have 10,000 polo shirts, all extra, 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 extra small. Oh, but here's exactly what you want. And it's also a crop top. Thank you very much. Okay, great. Having to, usually that's funnier. Okay, all right. I'm going to skip those. Man, one of the other things I liked about New York City was when doing comedy there is that you sometimes have to sell tickets in Times Square, which was a lot of fun. But I would compete against people who would lie about who's on their show. You know, the guy next to me, they'd be like, who's on your show? And he'd be like, Eddie Murphy's on the show. You know? And then they'd ask me who's on my show. And I didn't want to lie, but I knew, like, I was on the show probably a little bit. But, like, so I would just say my name as if it was as important as Eddie Murphy. They're like, who's on your show? And I'd be like, Paul Bennett's on the show. They're like, oh, who's that? And I'm like, you've definitely seen that guy before. When he gets on stage, you'd be like, I know that guy. Okay, all right, that was pretty good. Okay, all right. You got any kid jokes, or we should do another game?
Kid jokes!
What's that? What's that, Danny?
You got any index card jokes?
These are all index card jokes. What do you mean? Oh, jokes about index cards? That's a good, okay, all right. My stepdad. Thank you very much. Okay. Okay. What do we got? Ellie, do you have a kid joke? What do you got? No. You were just saying kid joke. You're just screaming them, and now you're just on your Twizzler, whatever thing that is. Okay. All right. Any other kid jokes? What you got?
No.
Who's there?
Isabella.
Isabella who?
Isabella Broken. I had to knock.
Nice. Well done. Well done. That's great. Cool. Any other ones? Okay. Let's do a game. Okay. Oh, this is the first time ever I'm going to try this one. I've never done this one before. Okay. You ready for this? This is I'm adopting a character. Okay. You guys ready? Okay. Right. Never done this. Okay. So kids, this is 100% true, sort of. I am the greatest magician in the world. Clap it up for me. Yes. Thank you very much. Thank you. People sometimes when they see my act, they say it's unbelievable, things like that. And if you could tell how I do these tricks, you win a big prize because no one's ever figured out my tricks, okay? Are you ready? Okay, so kids, Ellie, Diana, you're ready? Are you gonna try to figure these out? I bet you won't figure them out, okay? All right, okay. First, I will make this ball disappear. Are you ready? Okay. Thank you very much. The ball's gone.
Yeah.
Thank you. It's under my shirt. What are you talking about? Oh, yeah. Okay. All right. Good job. Okay.
You saw it.
Okay. Well, this one. This one will be better. Okay, this one will be better. Okay, you won't figure this one out. Okay, you ready? I'll make this ball disappear. You ready? Okay, ready? Ball's gone. What are you talking about? Just appeared over there. Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay. Okay, that pretty good? Okay. You guys, I won't throw it. I won't hide it, okay?
Uh-huh.
Are you guys ready? I'm going to make this bag of popcorn disappear. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're eating it!
I'm just a little hungry right now. Okay, is any kid, Diana, can you come here? I want to do a trick. It's a magic trick.
Me too.
No, well, it's okay. I'll just try with Diana. Okay, right? If you can figure out this trick. Ellie, if you can figure out this trick, I'm going to be so surprised, okay? I'm going to make Diana levitate. Okay, turn around. Okay, ready? Okay. Abracadabra, abracadoo. She's levitating. Thank you. Thank you very much.
I know
Thank
how.
You. How do you do that? What do you think?
You picked her up.
What? I didn't barely touching her.
You go like this.
Oh, whatever. Okay. All right. Thank you very much. Thank you, guys. That was my magic cat. The greatest magician in the world. So, thank you. Some people say I'm terrible, but I think they're saying I'm terribly great, right? What do you say? What's the review of my magic act? How good is it?
Oh, middle good.
Middle good? That's pretty good. That's solid. I'm not living with middle good. Yeah, I'll take that any day of the week. Dana,
I knew you were going
to
do that because I worked on your comedy with you.
That's true. Oh, do you guys want to play a game, Diana? We have a couple minutes left. So, kids, do you want to play a game? Oh, adults. Does any adults want to play this? This is a better adult-wise.
It's pretty fun.
Okay, it's pretty fun. Here it is. Diana invented this game. This is a game I'm going to need. You guys can do it from your seats, okay? I'm going to pick a topic out, and I need three volunteers. You can do it from sitting. Okay, Danny, Ellie, and Lynn, and Ann. Okay. All right, ready? Okay, so you have to guess. I just picked a topic out of a group of topics that Diana picked out, okay? So we'll see who can guess what it is.
Yeah,
who's the closest?
Hold it backwards so you can't see.
Here, I'm holding it so they can't see. Okay, ready? Okay, Ellie, what topic? What is this? What word is this?
AM.
AM? And the prize goes to whoever gets closest, okay? AM? Okay, Lynn, what do you got?
Mermaids.
Mermaids, okay. Ann?
Index card jokes.
Index card. It's a callback. That was good, okay. Danny?
Plant.
Okay. The answer is forget.
Oh.
I think Ellie wins. Good job, Ellie.
Yeah.
There you go. Okay.
That's pretty good.
Alright, okay. That was actually hold on, there's a good joke in there. Okay, I'll do a couple more jokes. Any other kid jokes? We're right near the end. What do you got, Dan?
Why do you want to eat
an
apple?
Why? There you go. What's worse than finding, what's worse than finding a worm in your apple? Finding half a worm. That's a good one, right? What's that? What do you got, Ellie?
Why do you want to eat a tomato?
Why? She's contemplating.
Why do you want to eat a gross tomato, I meant?
Oh, why do you want to eat a gross tomato? Why do you want to eat a gross tomato? Why?
To get sick even more.
Nice.
Because you want to watch TV all day.
Oh, there we go. I think we know what somebody likes. Yeah, what do you got?
Why do you want to eat the apple?
Why?
You ate the worm.
Nice. My older daughter, we used to do this comedy show. She would tell the same joke all the time, which was, what is green and red and goes round and round? A frog in a blender. How do you get the frog out?
Oh.
With a straw.
Oh.
Okay, all right.
Oh.
Is that not good? Okay, all right.
I got one there.
Okay, it's rock.
Knock, knock.
Well, yeah, who's there?
Mushroom.
Mushroom who?
There's mushroom for improvement on that last joke.
great. I love it. Okay, that's good. Oh, yeah, Sarah.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Amos.
Amos who?
A mosquito bit me. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Andy.
Andy who?
And he bit me again.
Nice.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Spinach.
Spinach who?
Spinaching me ever since.
That was pretty good. I like that. And you got one, Andrew? Who's there?
Sam and Janet.
Sam and Janet, who?
Sam and Janet.
Wait, what was it? Sam and Janet, what? I don't know that song.
Is that right?
Oh, okay. I'll try to look at my dad. No, I don't do that. My mom's a little hard of hearing, which, you know, was one thing is that, like, when you think someone's hard of hearing, like, you think it's just, like, what they don't hear, that's important, you know, but it's also what she makes up that's very important, you know? Like, I'll be like, hey, Mom, the pasta's over there. She'd be like, yes, I know I'm a great driver. You're a great driver, Mom. You're a great driver. Okay. The other thing is Halloween. Halloween around here is pretty popular, right?
Yeah.
And my mom was like handing out the candy, and she was like, I just couldn't do it anymore, so I had to like stop doing it. You know, stop doing all the candy for everybody in the whole house. I was like, Mom, your competition, if you didn't do it, was a bucket. You could just put the candy in a bucket. You know, no kid's gonna be like, hey, I don't want to go to the house with all that candy in that bucket there. Okay. That was almost funny. Okay, we'll just do a couple more jokes. And anybody do kid jokes to end? Any round, last round of kid jokes? And we'll call it. What do you got, Dan? Why do you want to what? Why do you want to cut off your hand? Why?
To make you bleed.
Okay, all right. I just so you know, Camera, she's not my daughter. Let's do a couple of these, and then, you know, for love and... Okay, so this one's love, something, okay, I don't know what that is. Love about moms is lightning like thunder. What does that even mean? That sounds awesome. Someone's got like a superhero mom. Great hugs, and last one that we love is snuggling before bedtime. Those are all great things, right? I should just end there. Okay, but I'll go with a couple of hates are, sorry, discipline. Oh, Mom, okay. We got, I wish you would feed me sweet treats. That's pretty solid. Who's that? Is that you, Diana? Oh, Ellie, there you go. Okay. And just the word never. I like that. And last one is, she cut out our bangs. Oh, when she cut her bangs. Oh, that sounds tragic.
No, when mothers cut your bangs.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a thing.
It's a thing?
I bang.
Okay, well don't.
It's the old photograph.
Okay, well don't let your moms cut them, apparently.
Okay,
well, thank you for coming. Clap it up for all the moms and yourselves.
Well, good afternoon and welcome out on this beautiful, beautiful spring Mother's Day. We are just fine, thank you. And thank you. And we want to wish all the earthly and heavenly mothers happy Mother's Day. And here's a little joke. The definition of a sweater is what you wear when your mother's cold. A one and a two and a one, two, three, four. Deep blue sea.
Thank you very much. So,
does anyone else here identify as a nerd? Yeah. And a dork. Well, this is a love song for nerds. Hold on just a second. Is that up high enough?
I'm having trouble because of the passive pickup. I'm getting a little bit of
hum. Yeah.
So I gotta bring it back just a little bit. I'm tweaking things up here as you go.
Okay. I can hardly hear.
I can hear you great.
You can hear me?
Yeah. We always have this problem.
Alrighty, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4. Vocals and ukes.
We're gonna do a little Texas swing tune for you now. You kind of like all different types of things. Hope you do too.
Mostly we hope you're just fine.
I think we should sing the winds. What's that song,
The Wind Cries Murray.
Yeah. The Wind Called Cries Murray.
The drummer suggests we sing The Wind Cries Murray.
That's a drummer's joke.
All right. Tap your little foot for me.
When a sugar cane time I'm around about you, I'll be walking with my sugar. Need that old sugar moon. Gonna drop in the line. I'm craving some sugar. Get that old sugar moon. Oh, I can see him right now. He'll get the calendar down. Scratch a circle around. Oh, they were all turned about. When it's sugar cane time, all around about you. Wedding bells. Sugar moon. side tonight, casting a spell with its silvery light. Dreaming about my sweetheart, sweet as he can be. Won't be long before he returns. Song coming up here for
That's
you.
That's right. Just gonna give myself a little. There we go. Okay, yes, this is a song by Blondie. It's called The Dreams Lost on Me. That she got her mother a Mother's Day gift. She got her a mug, and it said, what did it say? It said, from
the world's worst daughter, and I forgot to mail it, but I think she knows.
I'm not afraid of what's down below. relaxed or lazy. Gonna keep my vision hazy and the dreams lost on me.
Thank you. So little William went to Sunday school last Sunday, and the Sunday school teacher said, "Do you say your prayers before every meal?" And little William said, "Why, no, ma'am. My mom's a good cook." Those are all the Mother's Day jokes I have, so sorry. It's a lovely old tune. Maybe you all know it. All right.
It must have been England, way up in the blue.
Another oldie. Oh. Is you is or is you?
I looked at the wrong song. But I will play the right song.
This is by Louis Jourdan and Billy Austin. I feel like I'm at sea. The wind blowing. Here we go. Love him.
if I can get it straight, 'cause I want him. Well, I'm gonna ask him. This is something that we recorded, and it's out there on all streaming services.
Everywhere. Apple Music, Amazon, Spotify.
This is a Bob Dylan cover.
He gave. He said, every man's conscience is vile.
sober on the water. It's been there since June. Tree trunks uprooted beneath the high crescent moon. Feel the pulse and vibration and the rumbling force. Somebody is out there beating on.
Very important. All right. Oh, I'm not all right. She's just fine, thank you, but she's not all right. So this is a song. This next song is by Kirsty McCall. It's called In These Shoes. I think she was British. Yeah.
Yes.
Funny song. I heard it on the radio one day and I just started laughing. Always wanted to sing it.
I'm glad you did.
One, two, one, two, three, four.
Flavor going for their own little take on Love Potion number 9.
Oh, let me just check quick. Yeah. Real quick.
You bring your instruments outside and they let you know about it.
They rebel.
I can't imagine a more perfect day.
I think this is good enough for Shelburne Ballroom.
The weather or the tuning?
The tuning. Let's let the wind light down there. Boy, when the wind blows, you get a nice lilac scent. It's really nice.
Beautiful.
I don't know if you're smelling it out there, but it's quite lovely.
I have lilacs stuck in my music stand.
Love.
Pat on the drums.
You.
Yeah. From the Rhythm Nation of South Deerfield, David Shaw. All right. Dance hall.
Dance hall? Okay.
Is there a dance hall in Shelburne Falls?
No, there should be.
There should be.
Because then
Let's
they would
make
need
that
to.
Happen.
Yeah.
Yes. Because I'll tell you.
Sweetheart, can we dance at Sweetheart?
No, we should.
We should. Let's. Yeah. Let's petition.
Let's make it.
That sounds good. Well, just in case Love Potion number 9 doesn't work for you, we have more advice.
Up in the northern latitudes, gray skies dull your attitudes. Now's no time to weep and moan. Life's too short to stay at home.
To sound like I'm in Saddam Hussein's marble bathroom. So really crank up the reverb. Don't you love that sound? This song is by, it's done by Ruthie Foster, who is an Austin, Texas blues guitarist and singer. And she was inspired by a 1939 version of this song.
Oh, you know that. Oh, you know that. You know that death coming knocking on my mother's door, singing, "Come on, mother, ain't you ready to go?" My mother's stood right down and buckled up her shoes, and she moved on down by the Jordan stream, and then she shouted, "Hallelujah, done done my duty, God, I'm a traveling
Jew."
You know that I'm knocking at my sister's door, singing, "Come on, sister, ain't you ready to go?" My sister stood right down and buckled up her shoes, and she moved on down by the Jordan stream, and then she shouted, "Hallelujah, done done my duty, God, I'm a traveling
his shoes and he moved on down by the Jordan stream. And then he shouted, hallelujah, done done my duty, got on my traveling shoes. I know that he'd come knocking at my preacher's door, singing, come on, preacher, ain't you ready to go? My preacher walked right down and buckled up his shoes, and he moved on down by the Jordan stream. And then he shouted, hallelujah, done done my duty, got on my traveling shoes. Knocking at my front door, singing, come on, sister, ain't you ready to go? I'm gonna slip right down and buckle up my shoes. I'm gonna move on down by the Jordan stream. And then I'll shout, hallelujah, done done my duty, got on my traveling shoes. Since this is our last one, this is the universal question of should I stay or should I go?
We want to thank Anne for having us today out here at the Water Street Lawn where we love to come. And we want to thank Dave for doing sound for us.
Thank you, Dave.
And just being such a nice person anyways.
We should do some punk.
No.
Well, yes, of course we should.
Everybody loves punk, right? Yeah, of course.
Okay. One, two, three, four, one. Darling, you've got to let me know. Should I stay or should I go? If you'll say that you are mine.
Oh, you gotta let me know. Should I stay or should I go? It's so, like, something.
Thanks for hanging out for the last act of the weekend. I'm pretty excited to be playing here at the Water Street Barn again. I was planning on doing primarily a blues set today, but since we got some kiddos, I'll vary it a little more than I normally would. I was just going to do some blues. Hope you guys like the blues. I love the blues.
Love the blues.
Well, since I talked up the blues, I'll start with the blues. As soon as I find it. She don't need you. She don't want your hand. She got nothing. You don't understand. Back off, buddy. Best leave him be. Take off running, hunt deal with me. Pack your bags and hit the road. No, she won't change her mind. Leave the woman alone, man. Ain't no man telling her this time. His words, he got the past. Bet's back, baby. You can kick it. I ain't gonna watch, no, I ain't gonna let it stand. I know you don't need me, baby, but I'll help that guy understand. Packing bags and hit the road. No, she won't change her mind. Leave the woman alone, man. Ain't no man telling her this time.
Sure.
Take your white chrome and hit the bricks. You think you're bad, but you're just a dick. Take a hit, yeah, and head for the dawn. Cause that queen won't take it anymore. Pack your bags and hit the road. No, she won't change her mind. Leave the woman alone, man. Ain't no man telling her this time. Bags and hit the road. Now she won't change her mind. Leave the woman alone, man. Ain't no man telling her this time. Ain't no man, ain't no man. No, ain't no man telling her this time. Several daughters.
I forgot the clips to hold my music so it wouldn't blow away. Not a good move. All right, let's pick it up because that was kind of slow. Not the best of openers, shall
we
say.
It was a great opener. Yeah. Loved it.
I'm glad you enjoyed it. I enjoyed playing it, so I guess that works out nicely. Let's have some fun, shall we?
Mr. Cord, please don't do that again.
Then don't play with the cords.
Yeah, that, especially that orange one.
I
think
I thought you rolled over the part of the blanket with padded cord under it.
It's one of my favorite songs. It's normally done by an entire band with like three vocalists singing three different parts. But since it's just me, wish me luck.
You got it.
Thank you.
Chester Boyer House, maybe a nice Chesterfield or Holland.
Convince my mother to let me listen to that band just because they were called Bare Naked Ladies. Just a bunch of nice guys from Canada. What are you gonna do?
Yeah, I'm just worried about
dancing
that cord.
Is fully, fully encouraged, but not on the power cords.
Not on the power cords.
I'm gonna roll it.
You see that cord there, right? Plugs
not
in his
there.
Guitar.
So, yeah, there's lots of possible ouchies we want to avoid there.
Or bang
way out
there.
There's lots of
space to
dance.
Right
there over there on the shelf by the big view.
Would you dance with me?
Yeah.
Ellie, would you dance?
Go dance?
Okay.
I'm
in my bed, watch the clock tick and I think of you. Caught up in circles, confusion, nothing new. Flashback, warm nights, we left behind. Suitcase memories, time after, sometimes you picture me. I'm walking too far ahead. You're calling to me. I can't hear what you say. When you say, go slow, I fall behind. The second hand of mine. If you're lost, you can look.
This is a fun one. It's meant to be done with a full band, but it works on just acoustic.
Therefore, this one, please.
It's an original.
Therefore,
this one. It's also not capable. You ready to dance? Dance over there. Break me, baby, break me good. Take me, baby, take me now.
Shake me, baby, rock my world. Tell me, baby, tell me how. I wanna love you all night. I wanna hold you in my arms. I wanna feel you feel right. I wanna make you go. Make me, baby, bring me good. Take me, baby, take me now. Shake me, baby, rock my world. Tell me, baby, tell me how. Kids, and I'm like, let's sing about that stuff right in front of these two kids. I know, it's the beauty of it, isn't it? Still in the realm of blues, but this was one of those rare occasions where the blues hit the pop chart, the pop charts. If I could reach the stars, pull one down for you, I'd shine it on my heart. So you could see the truth that this love I have inside is everything it seems. Until then I find it's only in my dreams that I can change the world. You'll be the sunlight in the universe. Ooh.
it out. Air clap. Let's pick it back up a little bit. I say pick it back up, I turn to another Clapton song. It's Tears in Heaven. That is not picking it up.
Make it a polka.
Oh no, because I can hear that in my head now. Why did you do that to me, Dave? Why?
You're welcome.
So we had a really great weekend here in Shelburne Falls.
Another song you fucking dad said.
Tons of really great, just cool stuff happening out there. I mean, there was face painting and all sorts of like painters and a lot of painting going on. But over here we had some amazing music all weekend. And I will say, I am now a senior producer for Falls Cable, and I am the one who is filming all this hullabaloo, and it's going to be going up on the cable station as well as YouTube, so you guys are going to be able to watch and relive these performances forever and ever and ever and ever and ever until the world falls apart and there's no more YouTube, which hopefully won't be soon. As a wise man once said, we tune because we care. We really don't want me to play without tuning this.
She hands me my raincoat. She's always worried about things like that. She says it's all gonna be, it's all gonna be my fault. And she only sleeps when it's raining. And she screams, and her voice is straining. And she says, baby, it's 3 a.m., I must be lonely. When she says, baby, well, I can't help be scared of it all. Sometimes rain's gonna wash away, I believe this. She's got a little bit of something, but it's better than nothing. As high as it used to. And she only sleeps when it's raining. And she screams, and her voice is strained. And she says, baby, it's 3 a.m., I must be lonely. And she says, baby, well, I can't help but be scared of it all sometimes. And the rain's gonna wash away, I believe it. Believes that life isn't made up of all that you're used to. Clock on the wall, it's been stuck at 3 for days and days. She thinks that happiness is the mat that sits on the doorway. Outside, it's not raining. And she says, baby,
Matchbox 20. Now for something completely different. Makes me blue. Well, the music plays and you display your heart for me to see. Had a beer and now I hear you calling out to me. And I hope that I don't fall in love with you. The room is crowded, there's people everywhere. I wonder, should I offer you my chair? Well, if you sit down with this old clown, I'll take that frown and break it. Before the evening's gone away, I think that we could make it. And I hope that I don't fall in love with you. Well, the night does funny things inside a man. These old tomcat feelings you don't understand. Well, I turn around and look at you, light your cigarette. I wish I had the guts to bum one, but we've never met. And I hope that I don't fall in love with you. I can see that you are lonesome just like me. And it being late, you'd like some company. Well, I turn around and look at you, and you look back at me. The guy you're with, he's up and split. The chair next to you is free. And I hope that you don't fall in love with me. Now it's closing time. Fading out. Last call for drinks, I'll have another stout. Well, I turn around and look at you, you know where to be found. I search the place for your lost face. Guess I'll have another round. And I think that I just fell in. This is a fun one too, so I'll do this one as well. It's more Rob Thomas. I hope you don't mind. As soon as I can find it, I just had it. Then the wind blew it away. There it is. This is actually a collabo. Rob Thomas and someone else who is a much better guitarist than I am. But still, let's have some fun, shall we?
Everyone and you stay. forget about it.
Joy back there just making it so much better too. It's like there's this dramatic pause in the music and it's like ah! It's awesome. All right. Deep, 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 deep. As you can tell, I have a wonderful grand plan for all of this. I'm like, yeah, I'll play that. I've been so focused on filming and doing the sound for everything else, I'm like, oh yeah, I gotta do something now.
Nope, not that one. I can remember how to play it.
Desperado. Why don't you come to your senses? You've been out riding fences for so long now. You're a hard one. I know that you got your reason. These things that are pleasing you can hurt you.
Ben and I were always on the same wavelength.
Yeah, that was the Eagles, and then later covered by somebody on an album of covers that I don't know who did, but I really enjoyed it, but I have no idea who did it. I've only got time for like a couple more, and then I'm all done. Oh, yes. So I don't do a whole bunch of performing by myself, but I do host two open mics. One is actually in Greenfield every first and third Monday at Namaste, the Indian restaurant there. That's just started, so it's a fledgling little open mic, and I open it. My kids almost always perform, so that's fun. And I'd love to have you there, if just to listen, but hey, if you want to come up on stage and do something, that'd be great too. I also host a very popular, and it's been called the largest open mic in central Massachusetts, actually in Gilbertville, Massachusetts, which is a town, or a village in the town of Hardwick, which is a fly speck in the middle of nowhere. But it's a nice little fly speck, and I really like it, and it's at the Lost Towns Brewing, and we do that every Friday night. It's me and my sister, actually, we co-host it. And that's a big one. Both of these open mics are streamed on my YouTube, and if you're curious about seeing those, I have cards that have my YouTube on them, which is also where you'll be able to see this video when I'm done editing it. So this is, speaking of other people doing other people's stuff, this is a parody of a song that was done by Weird Al Yankovic. And I love it, so I'm gonna play it for you.
Giant carbonated soda. Yes, soda, soda. I saw the little runt sitting there on a log. I asked him his name in a raspy voice. He said, Yoda. Y-O-D-A, Yoda. Yo-yo-yo-yo-yoda. I've been around, but I ain't never seen. Like a Muppet, but he's wrinkled and green. Oh, my Yoda. Yo, 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 Yoda. Well, I'm not dumb, but I can't understand how he can lift me in the air just by raising his hand. Oh, my Yoda. Yo, 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 Yoda. Yo, 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 Yoda. With my Yoda. Yo, 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 Yoda. Yo, 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 Yoda. Yo, yo, Yoda. Yo, 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 Yoda. So I use the Force. I picked up a box. I lifted some rocks. I stood on my head. Forget what Yoda said. He said, Luke, stay away from the darker side. And if you start to go astray, let the Force be your guide. With my Yoda. Yo, 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 Yoda. No, Darth Vader's really got you annoyed. But remember, if you kill him, that you'll be unemployed. In a mess, so I'm gonna have to leave Yoda, I guess, but I know that I'll be coming back someday. I'll be playing this part till I'm old and gray. The long-term contract I had to sign said I'll be making these movies till the end of time. With my Yoda. Yo, 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 Yoda.
Yoda! Yoda!
I like how that was, I played the wrong chord and you're looking at my hand like it was my hand's fault. I'm like, what are you doing? I don't know. Neither do I, so it works out. We're a good team, me and my hand. So, one more, I guess. Huh?
Sounds good to you, sounds good to me. Alright, let's have some.
I'm gonna go right back around to the blues. I wrote it, but I can't remember the words, so I have to have the words in front of me to remind me of the song I wrote. The worst part is I've been doing this since I was 15. I think I'd be able to memorize something by now. But so thanks again for joining us here at the Spring and the Falls music event here at Water Street Barn. All the bands before have been amazing, and I'm sure all the bands that are coming after me in the next upcoming weeks are going to be amazing. I know most of them. I know they are. And yeah, just have some fun, love each other, and play as much music as you can.
Thank God for the rain.
It's been the shade that
helps me hide my tears. Thank God for the rain. Helps me soothe my fears. Yeah, my baby gonna let me. She let me cry in here. Oh, please rain keep on falling. Hide my bleeding soul. Yeah, my baby promised me forever until we both grew old. Yeah, my baby gonna let me. She left me crying out in the cold. She let me cry in those tears. Yeah, I said my baby gonna let me. She let me cry. No.
Thank you very much, guys. Appreciate it. See you all next time.